It has become necessary for me to address you, having heard from many concerned Nigerians and having concluded a meeting with all security chiefs. I must warn those who have hijacked and misdirected the initial, genuine, and well-intended protest of some of our youth in parts of the country against the excesses of some members of the now disbanded Social Anti-Robbery Squad, SARS. On Monday, 12th October, I acknowledged the genuine concerns and agitations of members of the public regarding the excessive use of force by some members of SARS. The choice to demonstrate peacefully is a fundamental right of students as enshrined in Section 14 of our Constitution and other enactments. But this right to protest also imposes on the demonstrators the responsibility to respect the rights of other citizens and the necessity to operate within the law. As a democratic government, we listen to and carefully evaluated the five-point demands of the protesters. And having accepted them, we immediately secured SARS and put measures in place to address the other demands of our youth. On approving the termination of SARS, I already made it clear that it will align with our commitment to the implementation of extensive police reforms. Sadly, the promptness with which we have acted seemed to have been misconstrued as a sign of weakness and twisted by some for their selfish and patriotic interests. The result of this is clear to all observers. Human lives have been lost, acts of sexual violence have been reported, two major correctional facilities were attacked and convicts freed, public and private properties completely destroyed or vandalized, the sanctity of the palace of a peacemaker, the Oba of Lagos, has been violated. So-called protesters have invaded an international airport and in the process disrupted the travel plans of fellow Nigerians and our visitors. All these executed in the name of the End SARS protests. I am indeed deeply pained that innocent lives have been lost. These tragedies are uncalled for and unnecessary. Certainly, there is no way whatsoever to connect these bad acts to the legitimate expression of grievance of the lives of our country. The supporting of deliberate falsehood and misinformation through the social media in particular, that this government is oblivious to the pains and flight of the students is a ploy to mislead the unwary within and outside Nigeria into unfair judgment and disrupting behavior. On the contrary, both our deeds and words have shown how committed this administration has been to the well-being and welfare of students, even with the steadily dwindling revenues and the added responsibilities and restrictions due to the coronavirus pandemic. Government has put in place measures and initiatives principally targeted at youth, women, and the most vulnerable groups in our society. These included our broad plan to lift 100 million Nigerians out of poverty in the next 10 years. The creation of 75 billion Naira National Youth Investment Fund to provide opportunities for the youth and the micro, small, and medium enterprises survival fund through which government is A, paying 3 months salaries of the staff of the 100,000 micro, small, and medium enterprises. B, paying for the registration of 250,000 businesses as a corporate affairs commission. C, giving a grant of 30,000 Naira to 100,000 artisans. And D, guaranteeing market for the products of traders. These are in addition to many other initiatives, such as A, farmer money, B, trader money, C, market money, D, empower, E, and tech, and F, and agro. New Nigerian government is the first and seriously across poverty elimination like we have done. With regards to the welfare of police personnel, the National Salaries, Income and Wages Commission has been directed to expedite action on the finalization of the new salary structure of the members of the police force. The enrollments of other paramilitary services are also being reviewed upwards. In order to underscore the importance of education in preparing youth for the future, this administration has come up with a new salary structure and other incentives for our teachers. Let me at this point reaffirm the federal government's commitment to preserving the unity of this country. We will continue to improve good governance and our democratic process, including through sustained engagement. We shall continue to ensure that liberty and freedom, as well as the fundamental rights of all students, are protected. But remember, this government also has the obligation to protect lives and properties, as well as the right of students to go about their daily businesses freely and protected from acts of violence. To our neighbors in particular, and members of the international community, many of whom have expressed concern about the ongoing development in Nigeria, we thank you and ask you all to seek to know all the facts available before taking a position or rushing to judgment and making hasty pronouncements. In the circumstances,